everyone. Today I want to show you a really easy way on how to extract numbers from a text using a formula in Excel. You can see I've got an example here which says tester 1000 and it's taking out the 1000. Now this formula is going to work whether the number's at the front, the middle, at the end. So let's change it up. A couple of numbers, a little bit of text, and it's brought back the 1111 at the beginning. I'll do it again with some text at the beginning, a hyphen, a couple of numbers in the beginning, a little bit more text, and a couple of zeros at the end, and you can see it's brought back the 77656 plus the three zeros at the end. So it's a really handy formula. There's a couple of steps to get it built, so let's get started and show you how it's done. Okay, so the very first thing we have to do is just get a formula and get the number of characters in this cell. So to do that, very simple len formula equals len, open bracket, cell A2, close brackets, press enter, and it brings back 8, which is correct. There's 8 characters in the reference cell. Now the next part of the formula, I'm going to show you what happens behind the scenes, but it will be very visible by the way I show you. So we're going to actually get the number of characters and bring back their individual results. So to do this, we'll do the formula equals row, we'll embed indirect, and we're going to go from row 1 colon, and we're going to go as long as the len formula. So we'll add len by doing and embed that len formula we had before, len open bracket A2, and break that formula down. So it's from, we're going to bring back all the rows from 1 to 8. And there you go. It shows it in this reference cell to show you exactly what's happening with the formula. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is instead of bring back the number of characters and referencing them 1 to 8, I'm going to bring back the actual character that is in each of those positions. So let's expand on that last formula by using the mid formula equals mid, and the text we are going to look at is A2, and now we're going to get the start number, which we know is 1 2 3 4 5, by using that last formula row indirect from 1 2, and we'll get the length of the cell, which is len A2. Finish that formula, and the last part of the mid formula is bring back the number of characters, which we only want the one character referenced from that row. And now you can see it's brought back the letters in order, or the characters in order, based on the cell reference. The next step is a very simple one. We're basically checking each of these characters numbers or not. So we're going to use the exact same formula we had in the previous step. We'll bring it into the cell here, but instead we're just going to see if it's a value or not. So it's as simple as equals value, open brackets, the same formula that we had before, close the brackets, and press enter. And you can see that each of the ones where there was a letter is bringing back an error, and where there's a number is bringing back the actual number. Now the final step of this before we join it all together is to just, instead of bringing back an error, we'll bring back a blank value. So we'll grab that formula again and we'll put it into the cell. And we're basically just going to see, is this formula an error or is it going to bring back a value? It's as simple as equals if error, open bracket. If that is an error, we're going to bring back double quotation mark, which is nothing. So now it's brought back nothing, 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 and the 2003 at the end. Okay, so now let's put it all into one easy to use formula. And if you like what you see, please subscribe or click that like button. It'll be really handy. So let's grab the formula that we've built up along the way. We'll copy that. And we'll start building the new formula, which is joining it all together equals text join, open brackets. The delimiter is going to be nothing, to apostrophe marks. Then type in true because we do want to ignore empty cells. And now we insert that formula that we've built along the way and close the brackets. Now I'll leave that up there just for a second so you can use it and check it out for yourself. Now press enter and there we go. The result is 2003 or 2003 like the formula before. Let's test it out. Couple of letters, couple of numbers, and you can see it's all built along the way. 98797, and that's correct. That's exactly the numbers in the cell. Now keep an eye out for the extract letters video. I've also got one of those, so keep an eye out for that one, and hopefully this helped. See you next time.